Hi, I'm Toby Bradshaw, the chair of the Department of Biology at the University of Washington, and I'm going to take you on a walking tour of the first two floors of the new life sciences building. As we walk up the feature stair on the west end of the building, we can look up to the top fifth floor of the building. The first floor is the public area of the life sciences building. There's a cafe where students and faculty and visitors can come and grab a bite to eat, something to drink, a cup of coffee, and walk along this beautiful sunlit corridor. This is a conference room, or also a small classroom, can be used for either purpose. As we walk along the corridor to the right, you can see the deck that is available for seating on sunny days and for public events. And you can see the greenhouse tops to the right of that. We're going to turn left down the main corridor on the first floor, and we're now approaching the authentic teaching labs. There are four state-of-the-art teaching labs for our undergraduates. Each lab has capacity for 24 students. We'll be using state-of-the-art equipment and facilities here. We're walking now into the active learning classroom. Has a capacity of 48 students and the instructor. This will have highly developed media capabilities and opportunities for students to interact with each other as well as with their instructor. Back out into the hall along the teaching lab corridor, and now into the second conference room or small classroom, suitable for example, seminars, whiteboard space for students to write. Past the cafe area again, and now we're going to take the feature stair up to the second floor of the life sciences building. The second through fifth floors are all identical to each other. They're all dedicated to intensive research. Each of the floors, two through five, houses 10 faculty, principal investigators, and their research staff. The total building capacity is about 400 people. We're walking now into the break room at the southwest corner of the building where people can eat lunch, and now into the secure lab area, the open offices where graduate students and postdocs, research staff have their desks. And on the right, you'll see the individual faculty offices. There are 10 faculty offices on each of the floors, two through five, interspersed with these breakout areas where faculty can meet with students and staff to outline new research projects, to work on the whiteboard, to brainstorm, to come up with new ideas for innovative research directions. And then from the whiteboard, we go straight into the implementation of those ideas in the labs themselves. 10 lab benches and equipment benches in each lab, an equipment corridor that contains energy intensive equipment such as deep freezes, and then a series of procedure rooms, small, medium, and large size rooms, suitable for specific activities such as microscopy, for example, or electrophysiology experiments, computing, anything that faculty wish to have isolated space to do. Through the doors, back out into the public areas, this wood structure is the elevator core that runs the full height of the building, covered with wood donated by Leopold Freeman Forests, LLC. I hope that you've enjoyed your brief tour of the new life sciences building, and we are invited to the grand opening in September of 2018.